My name is Javed Iqbal. Today I should discuss system administrator in order to define user and responsibilities and attach the responsibilities to the user. To enter into Oracle application, first of all, we should provide the appropriate URL. Through appropriate URL, Oracle login page would be displayed. Add here username is operation and password is welcome. It is by default provided by the Oracle. On Oracle applications, user should face two type of interfaces. Interfaces are user screen. One is Oracle form based applications that processing a large volume of transaction. Second is HTML based applications, a self-service web page applications. Through login page, user should enter into EBS home page. Essential Business Suite is a bundle of several integrated Oracle applications that allows enterprises to manage the business process effectively. These applications consist of HRM, finance and accounting, supply chain management, customer relationship management, manufacturing and project management. On EBS home page, on the left hand side, yellow folders are responsibilities. What is responsibility? Responsibility collection of authorizations allowing user access to specific Oracle applications. There are two categories of responsibilities. One is standard responsibilities that are provided by the Oracle itself, and the user who defined responsibilities are customized responsibilities. By click on the system administrator, on the right hand side, functions would be displayed. In order to define the user, we should use the path system administrator security user defined. On user window, yellow fields are mandatory that requires data entry and white fields are optional that allows data entry. At here, we should give the name of the user who operate the responsibility that concerns with the specific applications, username and password, and here we also change the date, effective date, because it is a test server. And we should attach here the system administrator responsibility to the application system administration that responsibility concerned to this application and security group standard. At here we also change the effective date. Now close the window and we should define the responsibility. On EBS home page, by click on the functions, a main menu window would be displayed. Through this window, we should also define the responsibilities. On the top, file view edit, this is a menu bar perform actions within the Oracle form. Second is toolbar, where tools is designed to open the window, to close the, to save the document. And here black hat, which is MDI, multiple document interfaces. It is house of all documents. MDI also uses to switch the responsibility. Third one is title bar, where responsibility name should be displayed. To define the responsibility, we should use system administrator security responsibility define. A responsibility window should be displayed. On responsibility window, we should provide the responsibility name, application name and responsibility key. On this window, we are defining the application journal ledger that concerns with the responsibility journal ledger. What is journal ledger? Journal ledger is a central repository of accounting information of a company. Entire financial transaction of a company is recorded in the journal ledger, and in journal ledger, organization structure is also to be established. At here, effective date should be turned into the past date because we are working on a test server. Data group. Data group lists the Oracle applications. Whenever we define the responsibility, one time application name must be mentioned in the data group. Request group. It is the collection of reports and concurrent programs that a user can run. Journal ledger. Use GL concurrent program to process the batch journal entries into the journal ledger application without interfering with any other work in the Oracle application. Menu, a restricted list of functions and reports which are associated with the responsibility through menu. Menu specifies window forms that responsibility can display. At here, user has also an option to exclude the menu which is undesired. Now save the work and close the window. Now re-again log in into the Oracle application by the username and password that we provided to the user. System should ask one more time password to be changed before opening the EBS home page. These are the further checks which are provided by the Oracle. Now we change the password one time again and then log in into the EBS home page. We should attach this responsibility to the users by a same path when we define the user. Through system administrator security user define, a user window would be displayed. At here we should attach the responsibility to that user.